You know, and Jamari here. Many people with borderline personality disorder, are they always splitting due to devaluation before they might ghost in a temporary what, or you might not know, but what becomes for many people the knowing that the person that you're with or that you were with borderline personality tended to have a pattern, a cycle of ghosting, like every week or every 2 weeks or once a month or whatever the frequency might have been, that they would just ghost you or say, I can't do this anymore and be breaking up with you or whatever the case. However, they would do that because not everybody with BPD is the same. And so when they have this cycle, when you start to see this cycle happen, like maybe it's every 2 weeks, maybe it's once a month, and it could be like less frequent than that. But they just all of a sudden withdraw, or they won't contact you if you're like not living together, etc. Or they'll leave. They'll pack up everything and leave. And so there's this, it's over, it's on, and then it's off, and then they want it on again. Or ghosting, and then within a week or two, starting to talk to you and coming back. This isn't always about a split to devaluation, which may occur to a degree, but that's not the main driver of this cycle. What drives this cycle for some people with PPD, because they're not all the same, they don't all have the same pattern cycles in various aspects of what BPD is and what they're going through and why they're going through what they're going through. The reason for this is the approach avoidance conflict in people with BPD untreated who will not be consciously aware of this themselves. They are experiencing, because people often report that when the person with BPD, whether they leave, it's split to devaluation that is basically final for all intents and purposes, and the relationship, you get ghosted or quote discarded unquote or whatever. It can sometimes go that way, but it's what and people report that happens so often after you just had a great week or a great 2 weeks or a great day or more better days than not. You were very close, and all of a sudden, boom. You know, if they do a split to devaluation and they're gone, or, you know, maybe some hovering, but this pattern of a cyclical period of time that you can see repeating itself over and over, whether it's once a week, once every 2 weeks, once a month, once every 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, when they're ghosting, when sometimes they're moving in and out, and if you don't live together, when you start to see this repetitive cycle, it's the approach avoidance conflict, and it happens more often than not after you've been close, because that brings up the fear of engulfment. That's what leads to the push away. They don't know this consciously, but they feel overwhelmed and controlled, and then they need to push away. And so they go away sometimes in this ghosting pattern, cyclical pattern. And then when they go away, they push you away, then they feel like you abandoned them. So then they get into abandonment, which if somebody's got a cycle, let's just take, for example, of because somebody commented recently on the channel, of 2 weeks, every 2 weeks they do this. They ghost, and then they come back in 2 week cycles, on and off and on and off. Well, then it's the getting too close, push away, and then they take that action, and they don't usually consciously know why. And then they will, you can call them, or they might call you, the Hoover, whichever way it goes. And then they come back. And so you've got an established cycle of a pattern, which many people with BPD have, but not all. And what's happening there, though, is they're in the approach avoidance conflict. They will leave and they will feel overwhelmed and controlled when they're too close or things are going too well. And they may or may not know that. Push you away, and then they feel abandoned, and then when they're in the abandonment fear, they want to come back. That is really a big red flag that you need to take care of yourself and end a relationship with these kind of cycles in them, because they aren't going to be able to be stopped or changed until unless the person goes and gets significant treatment, which means varying different degrees of time, but it could be a year to 2 years to 3 years, at least, for them to understand and be able to learn, depending what modality of therapy they go to, what's happening for them there. People with BPD that have these cycles that are untreated don't have any real awareness, often, more often than not, of what they're doing and why they're doing what they're doing. So again, if you recognize, as many people do, and I've had clients tell me this, and people on the channel, people on live streams have said, that it's every 2 weeks, or it's once a month, or it's every 3 months, whatever the frequency is, the pattern of the relationship is off, and then within that time frame again, the relationship is back on, and then the time frame, relatively speaking, again, and it's back off, and it's on, it's a push, pull, but in the most extreme way of push-pull, because it's not like push-pull can happen in ways where the relationship isn't off and then back on and then off and then back on, or you're getting ghosted and they're not talking to you for like whatever their cycle period of time is. But it's the approach avoidance conflict in BPD. They get, when things are going really well, they're untreated, they're not consciously aware of this usually. Things are going really well and then they need to push you away because fear of engulfment. And then they do that, and in these cyclical ways in which many do, not all do it this way, with BPD, and then they're gone. And then, yes, after a period of time in their cycle, they'll have the abandonment fear rise, and then they want to come back. And so what's driving them to push you away and to say the relationship is off or ghost, and then come back and it's on again and unghost you, they can stay in these cycles for some period of time. But people get drained. It's hardly the way to have a relationship. These relationships, again, present impossibility with people with untreated BPD and people with codependency in what are these trauma bonds wherein you're hooked to the intermittent reinforcement of when it's good, it's really good. And then there's the when it's bad, it's horrible. And in these cyclical periods of predictable cycles that many people with BPD do have untreated, then it's like, well, so you're just waiting for them to come back and it to be, quote, good, unquote, again, or great. But the point is, that's not healthy for you. And there's nothing's going to change that unless they engage significant treatment. So the cycles, it's not always that they split to devalue. Sometimes it's just the approach avoidance conflict. And then what drives them to push you away is it's not the same thing as necessarily a devaluation. It will be some degree of split, but they can also experience just feeling engulfed and overwhelmed and controlled and push away. And that doesn't have to mean a total devaluation split. In this cyclical pattern that many people have described and find quite draining and confusing. So I hope that was helpful. If you're in one of these cycles and you're recognizing it, it's really a sign you need to take care of yourself and you really need to end the relationship, which of course is very difficult, super difficult for people with codependency.